Hello everybody, my name is Shelly and I recorded this presentation from Brazil. I developed this work during my master's. The title of this paper is Value Generation of Companies and Customers by Means of Innovation, a Case Study of a Metro Rail Construction. The motivation for the development of this work was the need to show to the teams involved in the project that all challenges of the construction and operation of the train signaling system, object of this study, would generate value for the company and for the customers. I will talk a little more about the train signaling system in the research method. It's also important to highlight the economic moment in Brazil. This country needs to invest a lot of infrastructure to improve its economic and social development. At the same time, the Brazilian government is investing heavily in privatizations and concessions for public services. In this sense, the main objective of the government to execute the train signaling project was to improve the quality of services, in addition to reduce travel time and increase safety for users of this transportation mode. Nothing better than investing in innovation to succeed in this improvement. The idea is also to improve the flow of people to urban centers, and we know that the trains have a much greater transport capacity than other modes. The type of contract adopted for the execution of services to improve train transport is a public-private partnership, PPP. The factors leading to create a PPP are related with, first, the possibility of transferring the activities of the public sector for private sector, and second, the use of private research in order to make investments in public services. This research can be directed to other areas of public interest. And the most common benefits associated with the partnership are introduction of innovation services provision, allocation of risks for parties more able to manage them, efficient management of building and operate risks, and increase of operational performance. The PPP have also been adopted to control delays and high costs in public works, increase the efficiency in project management. For the specific case of the metro rail systems, the PPP contract was needed for modernizing the system, having a plan to expand the rail network with implementation of new stops, acquisition of new trains, replacement of signaling networks, and new lines to serve cities that still do not have transportation on rails. In order for the company to become competitive, it is necessary that it knows their needs, limitations, capacities, and skills. So it is in the strategic planning that the company discovers those internal demands. And the SWOT analysis is a technique used for the management and strategic planning of the companies. Since this tool points out the strengths, weaknesses, threats, and opportunities of the business, and this information helps to implement the strategic planning in the company, improve its performance. Regarding the generation value for the company operating the metro rail system, one competitive differential is the quality of the services provided. By the way, this is the same value perceived by customers. About this aspect, we can say that the increase in the number of customers is proportional of quality of the service provided. To develop this paper, the research method was divided in two stages. The first stage consists in a literature review about relevant concepts for this study. The second stage consists in a qualitative approach, and the chosen method was the single case study, due to the specificity of the theme. For data collection, semi-structured interviews were used. Besides the analysis of documents, such as project contracts and procedures. For professionals with more than 8 years of experience in project management and control were interviewed. In this specific case, those professionals participated in the implementation stage of the studied system. The criteria for selection of the case were access by the researchers to the key stakeholders in project documentation. The tree signaling project object of this study was an incremental innovation and consisted in implementing the metro rail signaling system to automatic train protection, ATP. The main objectives of implementing the project were to reduce travel time by using the system automation, to improve the security of users, considering the mechanisms of stopping in case of speed over the allowed one, to reduce the periods of system maintenance, considering the automatic operation of the system, and to the generation value for the concessionaire, both financial by means of the return of investment, as well as for the image of the company regarding users. As a result, the main strategy for generation value for the concessionaire was the investment in innovation of the existing structure, in order to potentiate customer services by implementing modern equipment and by the accessibility and enlargement of the metro rail system. Besides reduce the travel time of the railway composition, which would double the amount of travels. This figure shows the value chain used by the concessionaire studied. So, support activities involved customer service, management support, setting priorities, and hiring new technologies. About main activities, this involved analysis of innovation demands, qualification of employees, this topic is very important, performance analysis, quality of service, and process management. Margin involves the generation of productivity gains, personal satisfaction, motivation, achievement of strategic plan objectives, company image, and contribution to society. Being aware of these points is essential for business management. The challenges previewed for implementing the train signaling project, both on the technical part as well as one the organizational part, despite being studied and considered in the risk matrix of the project before implementation, proved to be more significant during the execution. The technical challenge involved 1. Precarious conditions of the existing equipments. The current system was implemented in the imperial period. A maintenance process remained stagnant without follow-up of technology advances until execution of this project. 2. Lack of functionality projects of the existing equipments. Due to the advanced age of the train network existing, several equipments did not have operations manuals and project of functionalities, demanding studies and the development of those projects by the hiring company in a much, much greater amount than the one estimated. Because of this reason, the deadlines for concluding the first stretch of the project were postponed more than once, because every week emerged a new need of adequacy to the existing structure. 3. Large extension and diversity of regions around the roads. Almost always, people access the train line and activity stops because of it. 4. Activities for project implementation were happening in parallel of the operation. And all infrastructure activities along the tracks, they passed by large restrictions of access and time, since the operation routine were disputed with the system maintenance. The organization challenge involved 1. Define the priorities and responsibilities of the project, training the teams for operation and maintain the system, strategic alignment of the project with the user needs, communication with customers, especially governments and users, about the delays implementing the project. And all these points are very important to project management development. This figure shows the role of integration in the management of other areas of knowledge. For coordinating all activities of project implementation, was necessary a good integration model for project management. Focus mainly on the constant changes of the scope of the innovation projects and help the implementation of the new technology. The implementation of the TransSigli project had well-defined goals with related the interests of the concessionaire and of the customers, such as reduction of the travel time, increasing the safety of users, reduced maintenance periods of the system, and generation value for the concessionaire. Gross operating revenue of 2016 researched a growth around 14% regarding the previous year. This growth is a reflex mainly in the increase of the number of transported passengers. As a contribution for literature is the relation that investments in innovation generate value for those involved from the following proportions. First, companies start to perceive the importance of the customers under the optic of the business and turn this as its attentions for it and not only for the product itself. And second, the technology evolution allows to improve the services from the needs of business and customers. This work also raises some important points common to other situations involving innovation projects, such as importance of integration between process and teams, need to train teams, very important in this case, need to outline strategic planning, cost benefits of innovation. Finally, it's worth to highlight that in this case study, the investment in innovation brings benefits for everybody involved. On the other side, the companies improve the results of the business and continue to invest in new technologies. On the other hand, customers have more quality and agility in services. These were the used reference. And any questions or interest in this work, you can send me an email. Thank you.